Hello children, in this video I am going to explain you about endocrine system. Basically this video is based on the introduction of endocrine system. So before introducing, I want to tell you that in our body there are so many organ systems. You all know that is digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system and other systems also. So as you can see here that these all systems work in our body in a coordinated manner. Okay, so that means without disturbing the functioning of other organ system or other organs, they keep on working and reaching to the ultimate goal, that is the living organism is able to survive in any condition. Okay, and also the timing and performance of one system does not disturb the functioning of other system. And one more thing it does, that it maintains homeostasis. So here I want to explain you what is homeostasis. Homeostasis is basically the steady state of physiological functioning. Physiological functioning, that means whatever the physiology is functioning in your body, that means the outer temperature and all like that kind of situation, that is called the homeostasis. So altogether I want to tell you that here is the control and coordination between the different systems present in our body. So body is one, but there are many systems and they all are working in a coordinated manner. Okay, it's not like that the digestive system will stop working, then only the respiration will work, or respiration will stop functioning, then only the excretory system will work. No, but what it does, digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system and other, that is the circulatory system, all the systems work together and it reaches to the ultimate goal. Now children, I want to tell you a little in detail about the homeostasis. What is homeostasis? It is what? Just for an example, if you are feeling hot, so what happens? Your body will start sweating. Okay, when you are feeling hot, your body will start sweating. Okay, or you can say you start sweating. So what happens in this case, that inside our body, the blood vessel expands and the body temperature decreases when we are sweating. Okay, sweating, it is making our body cool. Okay, from outside it is what, it starts, the sweat glands will start secreting and then the sweating process keeps on going. So that is, in that case, blood vessel expands and blood temperature decreases. And in second case, that is when we are feeling cold, then our body starts shivering by itself. Okay, we start shivering and in that case what happens, the blood vessel contracts and the body temperature increases. When you are during the cold weather, when after bathing, you can see that you feel shiver. So what is that shivering? When you are shivering, your body temperature increases just because the blood vessel contracts. Okay, and this is maintaining your body temperature. Okay, so sweating and shivering, that is the process which is balancing the body temperature. So balancing the body temperature, that is called the homeostasis. That's why it is told that it is the steady state or the constant state of the physiological functioning. Now children, as I have told you before, that we are going to study about the control and coordination, and inside our body there are so many systems and they work without disturbing the functioning of each other, and the timing and the performance will be also the perfect one, and it is just because they are having two kinds of mechanism. That means our body is having two controlling mechanism which results in the control and coordination of the body organs or the different organ system inside our body. So here we are having the chemical control and neural control. So two types of control are present in, control mechanism are present in our body, chemical control and the neural control. So here, dealing with the chemical control, there are some chemicals which are secreted and get circulated inside our body, and that is dealt by the endocrine system. And the another one is the neural control. So neural control, this is what, that is the nervous system here. So nervous system is doing the neural control with the help of the neurons. So here the neurons are responsible, and they are giving the nerve impulses, the signals, and then the control processes keeps on going. But here in case of chemical control, the hormones are responsible for the control and the coordination of the body and the systems. So this is the endocrine system, which we are going to study in detail. Now children, here you can see the differences between the chemical and the neural control. So here you can see on the basis of these characters, the chemical control and the neural control are differentiated. Okay, so system associated, that means which organ system is associated with the chemical control, that is the endocrine system, and with the this neural control, it's done by the nervous system. What are the structural components which are helpful in the chemical control and the neural control? That is, the secretory cells are there in the chemical control, which will secrete the chemicals, and those chemicals are the hormones. Okay, and the neural control, that is nerve cells or the neurons are responsible for doing so. Now, mode of transmission of messages, that means how the messages reaches and accordingly the person behaves. So that is the chemical messengers or the hormones are responsible for the chemical control, and they transmit through, they are transmitted through the blood. So blood stream is there, when wherever the blood will go, they will carry the hormones along with them, and but they will act on the target cell only. So here the nerve impulses are transmitted through the nerve fibers. Okay, so that is the bundle of nerves. And the what is the speed of transmission of messages? When we consider the speed, here you can see that the chemical control, the messages will travel very slowly, because you know your body, the blood has to travel in the whole body and then it will reach to the target organ. So it is what, it will take some time. So that's why messages travel slowly, whereas in case of neural control, the messages travel very rapidly. That's why you are able to act very fast. Okay, and your reflex actions are also dealt by the neural control only. Reflex action means sudden actions, just like the hot when suddenly you are touching the hot pan, so immediately you used to lift your hand from there. Okay, so what is that, and you feel the pain also. So that is what, the messages travel rapidly. And when we talk about the next, the last character, effect and the duration of the messages. So here in case of chemical control, effect is generalized or widespread, influences target cell only, whereas the neural control, effect is localized, affects only particular muscle or the gland called the effectors. Okay, so here the chemical control, there will be the you can say the permanent control will be there, whereas a neural control, there will be you can say for the short time interval, short time it is. Okay, so this is about the differences between the chemical and the neural control. In the next video, we will talk in detail about the endocrine.